As a teacher, I'm positive, I'm enthusiastic, I'm excited about new modern media. However, being negative, my first problem is money. Unfortunately, there's just very little money coming through. We want to do this, we want new equipment, we want the resources to develop it, but they're just not going to arrive. And I have to be realistic and think, where's the money going to come from? If I've got a group of 30 kids, I'd love to do this with all of them in one large group. But in order to do that, I've got to have at least 10 machines between them. And without that, it's just not going to happen. We do little things. You do an odd film, you do the odd photo-based revision of something, you're making images change, you're moving film, but you're only doing that with one person at a time, mostly. And a lot of the expertise of that is coming either from their knowledge or from a one-to-one situation. And with a group of 30 pupils, it needs a little bit more. And I think that's the first problem that we've all discussed. In school, we've got some PCs, we could do that. I mean, I've got a Mac at home, we've just bought a new Mac in school. In fact, I've got a nice new iMac. You know, I'm not going to run decent software on it, I'm just going to use iMovie. And I will be able to make some films, but not in the quantity and the quality that I think we could and should be making. You know, and I think in order to do that, you've got to have far more resources in the classroom. You know, you can't rely on just what the kids have got at home. And again, mobile phones, great. Cheap, easy resources, lots of it about. Instantly, you've got problems with child protection, filming, if they're filming each other, if they're filming one another, if they're filming themselves. Are those images going to go on the internet? You've got a lot of child protection issues that schools need to think about if they're going to use these resources sensibly in schools. Cut an hour?